Very often these days, people will send me links like this and ask me why I do not recommend Windows Defender as a standalone product. Now, if you see here this chart by AV Comparatives for March 2017, Windows actually did quite okay. In fact, it did a lot better than some of the other security products. If you look at this graph and you see Microsoft, 99.7%. That's pretty good. So why do I still not recommend it? Is it because I'm biased? Because I don't want default protection to do well? Because then I would be out of things to review? Maybe. But before you say that, I just want to show you something and justify why I do not like Windows Defender. Now, don't get me wrong, I would love Windows Defender if it was good. If I felt it could protect you against all sorts of threats, I would be happy to recommend it. But at this point, I just do not see that happening. Maybe it'll happen in the future, and if it does, I'll be one of the first people to tell you that you don't need an antivirus, don't waste your money, just use default protection. But that's fantasy land. Let's take a look at reality. So on this system, I have Windows Defender fully up to date. Let me just show you that it is. And yeah, I don't have the new GUI because this is the Enterprise edition of Windows that you're looking at, but it's still basically the same software. If we go into settings, everything is turned on, cloud-based protection, automatic submission. I've done absolutely nothing to reduce its effectiveness. Now let's grab a recent ransomware sample. What I could find was mole ransomware. I've already made a video on this new threat family, so if you want to check it out, you can. I will add it at the end of the video and as a card as well. But for now, it's sufficient to know that this is a relatively new ransomware sample. It was posted by Karsten on Twitter a few hours ago, and as you can see, it looks fairly legitimate. So now let's see what happens when we run it. First, you get this weird display color calibration error, and you hit OK. Oh, I need to allow this app to avoid the error, traditional user mindset, so I click yes, and immediately Security Center is disabled, and I'm seeing weird stuff on the desktop. That can be good, right? Let's see what happened to our files. Whoops. The mole dug its hole in our system, despite Windows Defender hanging around. Now, this is not something I want you to have to deal with. I do not want people who watch this channel to end up in a situation like this. And that is primarily why I do not recommend Windows Defender as a standalone. Now let's talk about this a little bit. Now if we take a look at the virus total results, we can see that the detection ratio is only 15 out of 60. So you might say, hey, there are a lot of other AV products that are not picking this up as well. It's fairly new. So why are you bashing Windows Defender? Now we get to the point. So the point is, a lot of these products which are not detecting it, based on their signatures or heuristics or with their file scanner, they are still going to block it when the file is run, maybe with an anti-ransomware component, maybe with a behavior blocker. In majority of cases, with good products that you see reviewed on TPSC, they will have a secondary line of defense. So even when the product is not detecting the threat, it may be blocked, especially when it's a major threat, not just adware or something that's very close to blurring the lines. But what I've seen with Windows Defender is that if it's not detected here, it is not detected, period. And this is not the only file I've picked up that is not detected by Microsoft over here. I see files like that every day. They do eventually pick it up, but I'm kind of uncomfortable with that long of a time span, especially with these scam campaigns these days. So if you're one of the target victims, then you might just get the file the moment it is seen in the wild as an email attachment. So taking all of these things into account, I just do not like using Windows Defender alone. Don't get me wrong, if you use Komodo Firewall or something else along with it, totally fine. But is it complete protection? I don't think so. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. I'd love to hear them. I hope you enjoyed this video, and as always, stay informed, stay secure.